The first example that we'll look at is how control and data transfer is affected in Zen for network virtualization. Each guest has two I/O rings, one for transmission and one for reception. If the guest wants to transmit packets, it enqueues descriptors in the transmit I/O ring. And placing these descriptors in this I/O ring is via hypercalls that Zen provides for guest operating systems. The packets that need to be transmitted are not copied into Zen, but the buffers that contain these packets are in the guest operating system buffers. And what the guest does is it embeds pointers to these buffers in the descriptors that have been enqueued for transmission by hypervisor. So in other words, there's no copying of the packets themselves from the guest operating system buffers into Zen, because the pointers to the guest operating system buffers have been embedded in these descriptors. And for the duration of the transmission, the pages associated with these network packets are pinned so that Zen can complete the transmission of the packets. Now, this is showing the interaction of one guest operating system with Zen. Of course, more than one VM may want to transmit. And what Zen does is it adopts a round-robin packet scheduler in order to transmit packets from different virtual machines. Receiving packets from the network and passing it to the appropriate domain works exactly similar to what I described for transmission, except in the opposite direction. What Zen does when it receives a network packet intended for a particular guest, it exchanges the received packet for one of the guest operating system page that has been already provided to Zen as the holding place for incoming packets. In other words, in order to make things efficient, what a guest operating system will do is pre-allocate network buffers, which are pages owned by the guest operating system. So when a packet comes in, Zen can directly put the network packet into the buffer that is owned by the guest operating system and enqueue a descriptor for that particular guest operating system. So once again, we can avoid copying in the direction of going from Zen to the guest operating system. So one of the cute trick that Zen also plays is that when it receives a packet into a machine page, then it can simply exchange that machine page with some other page that belongs to the guest operating system. And that again is another trick to avoid copying. Either the guest can pre-allocate a buffer, in which case Zen can directly put that packet into that pre-allocated buffer, or if Zen receives a packet into a machine page, it can simply swap that machine page for a page that the guest already owns. So those are two different techniques for avoiding copying altogether in the reverse direction as well.